Okay, today before we play some games, we've got some games set up over there. But today we're just going to learn a little bit about the book of Romans. So this is after Acts. Our first book after Acts is actually a letter. So this is called an epistle in the King James English. An epistle. Why is it called the Romans epistle? Because it was a letter that was written by Paul to the Romans, to those people that lived in Rome, to the believers there. So if you remember, Romans is a letter that's written by Paul. So it starts out in Romans 1, because remember when we learned about Paul last week, he was not ashamed about preaching the gospel. Look what it says here. This is Romans chapter 1, a verse from there. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. What's the gospel? The gospel is the death, burial, and resurrection. For it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. So you see, the gospel is we need to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. And Paul says here in Romans, he's not ashamed of the gospel. What does that mean? He's not fearful or scared that people know he's a Christian. He's not ashamed of believing and teaching the truth. So if you remember last week when we looked about the life of Paul after he was converted, you know, he met Jesus on the way to Damascus, and then he went and spoke to Ananias and got baptized, and then he was able to see again. He went and preached the gospel. So this is what he's doing in the book of Romans. He is preaching the gospel to the Romans via a letter that he's writing to them. So if you remember, we did this last week. Paul was let down by a basket, so he was not ashamed to preach this gospel. He even had to go to jail, you remember, with Paul and Silas. And then he was under house arrest. So one thing we learn in the book of Romans is something called the Romans Road. That's what it's known as. What do you think the Romans Road is? Has anyone heard that before? The Romans Road. Because Romans is about preaching the gospel, it's about how we get to heaven. And because when we read through the book of Romans and Paul is explaining in detail the gospel to the people at Rome, we see some key verses in the book of Romans explaining how we go to heaven. And that is known as the Romans Road. That's what it's been called. So we have the book of Romans. We think about the road that takes us to heaven. So that's why they called it the Romans Road. So we're just going to look at a couple of verses in this Romans Road and explains to us how we go to heaven. So the first verse that is known in the Romans Road is Romans 3:23. What does this say? For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. So what is this verse telling us? This verse is telling us that none of us are perfect. We've all sinned. What does sin mean? Sin means we, do you know? That's exactly right. Yeah, when you do something wrong, when you break God's commandments. So when you do something wrong is when God tells you not to do something. Like God says, thou shalt not bear false witness. Who's ever told a lie before? Well, I know I've told a lie many times. So we're all sinners. That's what this verse is saying. It's saying we all have sinned. And because we've all sinned, we come short of the glory of God. That's the first step on the Romans Road to heaven. The second step, this is a picture we're familiar with, aren't we? You know that Jesus died on the cross for our sins? Romans 5:8. Excuse me. Look at what the Bible says. But God commendeth his love toward us. How did he commend his love toward us? In that while we were yet sinners, remember the first Romans Road step was all have sinned, that's all of us. Now we can ask some more questions afterwards. In that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. So that's the second bit, that Jesus Christ died for our sins, even though we were sinners. Now, the third step in the Romans Road is Romans 6:23. So notice how all these passages are in Romans. So this is why it's known as the Romans Road, because there's these key passages in Romans that explain how to get to heaven. Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death. So what do we get because of our sin? We get this spiritual death. Who knows what that's called? the spiritual death. Where do you go? That's it. You go to hell. It's described as a lake of fire in Revelation. Sarah, sit down. Sit down on your seat. Look at this. For the wages of sin is death. But, oh, so there's good news. So this is the bad news. But the good news is the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. So through the death of Jesus, he paid a gift for us. It's not a physical gift like this picture, it's a spiritual gift. That if we believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, we get this gift from God, which is what? What's the gift? What is it? Eternal life. That's right. How long does eternal life last for once you get it? Do you know? Forever. That's right. So if you believe on Jesus Christ, this is saying, hey, you're going to live forever spiritually. We all die physically one day. Why? Because our soul separates from our body. If we believe on Jesus, our soul will go on to live forever in heaven as opposed to being dead in hell. And the last one on the Romans road to heaven is Romans 10:13. What does this say? So this is how you receive this gift of eternal life. For whosoever, that's anybody, whosoever means anybody, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. So all we have to do to go to heaven, according to the Romans road, we believe on Jesus Christ, and then we call upon the Lord. We tell Jesus that we believe on him. And that's how we receive this free gift of eternal life. So that's something we all have to do. We have to make sure we do it personally. You know, you may have come to church today because of your parents, but you don't get to heaven because of your parents. You can't get to heaven and say, oh, let me into heaven because my parents are Christians, right? You need to make sure you all believe, you individually. So you have to decide, I'm going to believe on Jesus. I'm a sinner. And then you call upon the Lord. And then when you do that, you can have eternal life. Just like this girl here is calling upon the Lord. You just pray to God and tell him that you accept him as your savior. But the Romans book doesn't stop there, because salvation is just the first step of our spiritual life, isn't it? We get saved, now we're born again, we have eternal life. But does it stop there? No, it doesn't stop there. Our salvation is complete, but God wants us to live a life that's pleasing to him. So in Romans 12, look at what it says here. I beseech thee. What does beseech mean? It means like I beg you. When you beg somebody, it means you're asking them, right? You're asking them really earnestly. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God. What's his mercies? Mercy, the fact that he saves us and he blesses us. That ye present your bodies a living sacrifice. What is a sacrifice? You know what a sacrifice is? A sacrifice is when you kill something in place of something else. But look at what the Bible's saying here. God wants us to be a living sacrifice. Isn't that weird? Because a sacrifice is meant to die. But then God wants us to be alive and yet yield, give our life to him, right? Give our bodies to him. Not in order to be saved. So we're not talking about going to heaven anymore. We've already finished the Romans road to heaven. Now that we're saved, what should we do? We should present our bodies a living sacrifice to serve God. Holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Okay, so that's what God wants us to do. Let's read this one together. This is our last verse. You ready? Romans chapter 12, verse 1. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. So we see this lady here giving herself to God, saying, hey, God, I'm going to do whatever you ask me to do. That's what it means to be a living sacrifice. So that's the book of Romans. So this is this letter that Paul's explaining to the believers at Rome. Hey, this is the gospel from beginning to end, and then exhorting the believers at Rome to present their bodies a living sacrifice and serve God with their life. Okay, so I hope you guys all do the same. All right, we got some games today. So I hope you learned something there. Yeah. We're gonna go play some games because we've been doing crafts for the last couple of weeks. So we'll go over there. We'll split you guys into teams.